Say you have a very simple texture pattern, a checkerboard consisting of just 4 texels. What happens if you put this texture on a square? There are now many pixels all sampling the same texel. The obvious answer is that you want this texture to continue to look like a checkerboard, with a sharp edge between the squares. In other words, you want something like this, nice and crisp. However, if you view this texture from a different angle, it doesn't look so great. This is a zoomed-in view, just to drive home the point. You get this stair-stepping effect instead of nice smooth edges. This is called the Jaggies. The problem is that the texture will return either black or white at every pixel. You'd like 50 shades of gray or so, but there's only these 2 levels. Sampling the texture in this way is called nearest neighbor. Whatever texel center is closest to the pixel center is the color the pixel gets. The other option is bilinear interpolation, or linear for short. What this mode does is takes the 4 closest texel centers and interpolates among them. The closer the pixel is to the texel center, the more of that color you get. If you turn on bilinear interpolation, this is what you get. That's definitely too much of a good thing. You'd like blurring along the edges of the squares, but not across the whole texture. The problem here is that one texel covers a huge number of pixels. Let's say we aim to change this ratio to be about 1 texel per pixel. In other words, say our original 2x2 checker pattern covers 100 by 100 pixels. To bring the ratio of texels to pixels to be closer, let's make the 2x2 checker pattern be represented by an image texture of 64 by 64 texels, so that each checker square itself covers 32 by 32 texels. In other words, we'll just make the same pattern but with a larger texture. Each texel in this larger texture will now cover around 1 pixel. This turns out to look pretty good. The stair steps are gone. You'll try the demo in a minute and see for yourself. In 3JS, setting the filtering to be nearest or linear is straightforward. There's not a lot to it. Using bilinear interpolation causes more taps to occur, that is, more texture samples to be retrieved, but it's usually what you want. Generally, you should use linear, which is the default. At the same time, you want to avoid situations where a texel covers a lot of pixels. Here's our original 2x2 texture. When we have a situation where a texel covers more than a pixel, this is called magnification. When magnification is occurring, the texture's mag filter is used. Another way to say it is that if the number of texels divided by the number of pixels is less than 1, magnification is happening. You're magnifying the texture. Say we zoom out on our 2x2 texture and it all falls within 1 pixel. If a texel covers less than 1 pixel, that is, 1 pixel contains more than 1 texel, this situation is called minification. In this situation, the mag filter is not used. We'll deal with minification and how to set the corresponding min filter in the next lesson. At this point, I want you to study a demo, as I'll be asking you about it. Try out various resolution textures and see how they work with nearest neighbor and linear filtering. Try the higher resolution texture patterns and try tilting the view to see what happens. Then play with the zoom.